A master's degree in anthropology is a really useful social science degree.
With anthropological fieldwork, generally anyway, you often go where you don't expect to go. I'm a cultural and medical anthropologist, and I'm an assistant professor in the Department of Anthropology here. We're a three-field department looking at socio-cultural anthropology, archaeological anthropology, and biological anthropology. And we're committed to conjoining those together and making sure that all of our students get a reasonably holistic knowledge of all of those fields.
In developing our graduate program, we chose to have public issues anthropology. We are trying to take the study of anthropology and apply it to real-world problems.
Unlike psychologists, anthropologists look at knowledge as properties of communities, you know, not necessarily of individuals, and that's relevant to public issues context, you know, when conflict occurs, as it does so often.
The public issues side of it makes it really interactive and something that's applicable to almost anything. My research is to look into 3D printing and its uses for artifact preservation.
We have a wonderful faculty here in the anthropology department. All of them are very good teachers.
Students get a lot of attention. And I also get to learn about new things of my own that I don't get through my own research. I think we all really enjoy our graduate students.
I'm supervising a number of graduate students this year, and I think that relationship between supervisor and student is very important.
My research is in double burials within Mycenaean Greece. She'll give me my space to do my research, but she's still, you know, obviously taking an interest in how I'm doing and making sure that I'm on the right track.
My research is interested in looking at the preservation of ballistic trauma in burnt remains. I was interested in bones since day one. I got to know Dr. Mariah Liston, and she slowly started to introduce me to forensic anthropology and biological anthropology.
The teachers are all very welcoming. They've made it very clear to come ask them questions.
I'm working on environmental anthropology and the anthropology of science. This semester I'm working with a TA in an undergraduate class on visual anthropology. In that class, the teaching assistant is like the writing coach for the students.
We try to offer our graduate students the chance to do field-based research.
Adjunct faculty members work in archaeological excavations in Ontario, and students do get involved in that.
Most of my research is in anthropological archaeology. I was involved in the search for the lost chips of the Franklin expedition. I've had students working on my archaeological materials.
It is a very small department, and in that sense, it's actually really nice. Going into a classroom and having four students and one professor is actually really, really incredible.
Everyone's really close, you know, we all work together. Team. So everyone's always interested in each other's topics and they're always willing to lend a hand.
Our graduate students have gone on to an array of different career paths.
Some continue in PhD programs, others have found jobs in museums. There's one who works in the forensics department of the Ontario Police.
If you don't want to go into academia, there's a lot of other public jobs that are available. My time here at Waterloo has been really, really rewarding and really positive.
I think the anthropology program here at UW is great because it definitely tries to get all four fields in. The public issues make it very relevant for today, and so I think it makes it a great choice.
One of the unique features of the public issues anthropology program is that it's at the University of Waterloo, where there's such an interest and emphasis on putting knowledge to work. Idea is, you know, to make our students global citizens acting out there in the world, and that seems to work.